I'd like to try it. I want to travel into the past.
It can't hurt to try. Send me to the past.
I'm going to need something.
Are you absolutely certain? The past is a strange place.
Tell me about it.
Well, listen.
Okay.
And the world was the same, and yet different.
What?
Okay, we're in the Nintendo version.
The books are still rotten. I mean, already rotten. I haven't gone back far enough.
This is hilarious.
No sign of whoever was supposed to repair the roof. The water is just going to drip through come the next storm. Not that it would make any difference for those books now. The books are still... I haven't... Hello? Can you still talk?
What do you mean, still? We've always been able to speak. We are living books. And you are?
Wilbur. From the, from the future.
Naturally.
Tell me.
Why does everything look strange in here?
Why does everything suddenly look so strange in here?
Strange? What do you mean, strange?
Not normal.
Never looked any different.
But it did. In my time, it was all much sharper and somehow more detailed.
Oh, so things look sharper in the future.
Yes, it feels a little harder to move about, too.
Have you suffered a knock to the head recently?
Not as far as you know.
You should consult a medical.
It looks like the books are all moldy.
A tragic story. A few years ago, somebody was supposed to repair a hole in the roof, but they forgot.
That's why I'm here. I just don't think I've traveled back far enough.
You don't say.
That's the skeptic book. Where's the time travel book?
A book about time travel sent me here. Where is it?
Oh, what are you, bound and gagged?
Huh. I'm just gonna take a little look around here.
Please yourself.
The books aren't very helpful. They don't believe in time travel.
So funny.
I'd love to see what the rest of the school looks like right now. But I'm just here to save the books. And there are more than enough things that need doing back in my time.
Right, and they didn't want to program that all in. Desk.
No trace of the librarian at this point in time either. There's a few broadhead nails. Maybe for nailing books with wooden covers. I'll take a few.
Bloop! Hilarious.
Some short nails with broadheads. The fire spell! Finally! Now I can start a fire anytime, anywhere.
Alright, he says the same stuff. Free the time travel book.
Burying a book underneath its peers. How could you? What the others did
to you
weren't very nice.
Books are very stubborn. Once you've written something in them, it's very difficult to change their mind.
What mind? They have minds? So it worked. I'm really here.
It actually worked. I'm really here.
I'm pixelated.
That can't be disputed, but what worked?
Time travel, whatnot. You sent me back to this point in time.
It worked?
Yeah.
Great Scott! It worked! I always knew it would!
Send me further back in time.
Send me a few more years into the past. Please.
Can't wait to see this. What are we going to be stuck in DOS?
Tell me about the past, and I imagine exactly what it was like.
I see. All right. A few years ago, things were very different around here.
Oh, that's, hello? Hello? Shh, This is a library. Why are I shouting like that? But that's just it. I can't hear myself. What do you mean you can't hear yourself? The words I'm saying, I've been struck dumb. You're talking nonsense. If you were mute, how could we talk to each other? I don't know. Okay, so this is definitely Sierra. This is CGA stuff. The books are fine now. There's a ladder, actually. Let's look at these books. The further you travel into the past, the more Spartan everything seems to be. Back then, or now, back in this day, there were only a handful of stuff. What would happen if we just kept going further back in time? Would I eventually just dissolve? The ladder leads up to a gallery. From there, you could probably reach the roof. Hey, you're intact. Why shouldn't we be intact? Because of a hole in the ceiling, the rain will fall through and you'll get wet. Oh, someone will take care of that. I've come from the future, and let me tell you, you're in terrible danger. Huh, you youngsters always have to be so overdramatic about everything. But we've hardly been lying here for a few years, and now you want us to move elsewhere. Strength is born of calmness, my hectic friend. But the roof, the hole, gah. If you'd only move just a little to the side, you'd stay intact. You need to slide over the side a bit, then the water can't hurt you. We're too old to move. Anyway, here is our rightful spot. That spot can't be that important, especially not when your lives are at stake. Not that important. This place is exactly the right distance from the fireplace in order that we stay warm but not get too hot. In summer, two air streams meet here from there and there. From here, what? And there we have the whole room in view without having to turn around. We're staying right here. It's our spot. So I don't have time to read all this. Where's the workman who's supposed to be fixing the roof? I see the ladder and the tools, but I don't see the workman. Oh, he's just gone out to fetch something. I'm pretty certain he won't be coming back. Why? In spring, it'll be only 5 years since he disappeared. Sometime in the next 20 years, someone will take the ladder and the tools away. By then, you'll already have rotted. Now listen here. That's not the kind of thing you say to old books. We've probably got a good century or two ahead of us. I'll be right back. We'll be here. Yes, that's exactly the problem. Hello. What is it now? Toolbox. A toolbox! Finally, a trace of our unreliable workman. Locked. Toolbox is locked and there's no sign of the workman. There you are. You could have warned me that you can't hear yourself talk back in this time. It's quite irritating. Do I know you? You're the time travel book, aren't you? No. I've only just been bound by the librarian. I know you from the future. You're a book about time travel. I know what your theme will be. Time travel. Time travel sounds quite crazy. Yes, but it works. At least in this room. You sent me here. Me? You? Time travel? You are the only book that knows anything about it. However, that does cause a few problems. Yes, but time travel. I'll learn everything about it. The words will fly off my pages and everyone will want to read me because only I hold the secrets to time travel. Hooray! But wait! Oh, you got legs. Get back here. Now, how do I get... Alright, need to get up. Without tar paper or something like that, there's no way I can fix the roof. Well, let's see what's up there. The ladder leads up to a gallery. From there, you could probably reach the roof. keys? No. Automation spell? The open spell isn't supposed to work, yeah. Too funny. This is funny. This is a funny surprise, that's for sure. Definite King's Quest homage here. And well, games from this era in general. Right, no. I don't have a lot of things I can use. I'm just trying random stuff now, sorry guys. Why are we trying so hard to save these books again? Disappointed I can't use the keys on that. Okay. I'm out of ideas for right now. Do you perhaps know anything about time travel? I might be a little stuck here in this time. Aren't we all? Well, yes, but I'd really like to go back to my own time. Us too. Everything was better in the past. Look at all this newfangled gadgetry. All that the youth is interested in is colorful pictures, and then there's the dreadful music everywhere you go. It was different in the past. People still read. Could you tell me more about back then? Of course. Everything was wonderful. You're in a brightly lit library. A fat man in dungarees is sleeping in front of the blazing fireplace. The distinct odor of alcohol hangs heavy in the air. Look at the library. You look around with your eyes peeled. No ladder, no toolbox, but there is a roll of tar paper. I have a feeling that this workman isn't particularly well organized. We're going to look at everything first. The old books. You look at the old books, which are lying in their place just like they were in the other time. As might be expected, they're safe and sound and haven't moved an inch. Oofing paper. A roll of tar paper, several paces long. That should be more than enough to repair the roof. Talk to the library. Hello? Anyone there? You listen attentively, but there's not a sound to be heard. It's as quiet as a, well, as a library. Yourself? This is way beyond weird. The world consists of nothing more than letters and some symbols. One thing's for sure, I'm not going any further back. Talk to the old books. Hello? Who are you? The workman's assistant? You could say that. How long has the workman been lying there drunk? Seems the workman hasn't gone very far with the roof. He brought in the roll of roofing paper today. Good man. Good man? Why'd he stop working? Today, you young people, always in such a rush. Then everything has to be done in a hurry. But at least it does get done. Ha. The workman knows you get a better result in the end if you're calm and plan precisely. Did it always look like this? How else should it have looked? Well, more colorful and more to see, less to read. Why should one want to see things rather than read about them? How are you supposed to see the sweet scent of jasmine on a spring morning? Or see that I don't trust you because you're wearing the same kind of hat as a teacher who trapped me some years ago? There's no sensible reason why one should go without all of this. I'll be back soon. If you must, take the roofing paper. Right. You take the heavy roll of roofing paper and add it to your immeasurable inventory. I want to look at inventory. Look at the, yeah. Talk to the workman. Hello? Excuse me? The sleeping man lets out a short grunt and you're not sure if it was intended for you. Hey, wake up! You have to repair the roof! The man doesn't react. He's sleeping soundly. What does he do after this? Just die or something? Talk to, you again! I'll be right back. Take the library. I can't take that. Take a wine bottle. The bottles are empty. I don't need empty bottles. Then again, I don't exactly need full ones either. Yeah, I just want to see if it would give me a different response. Use the library. I don't know how I'm supposed to use that. Excuse me. Use the old books. I don't want to read right now. Use the flap opening spell with a wine bottle. The wine bottles have already been opened and emptied. The old books. If I wanted to read those old books, I could just open them by hand. Use the fire spell with the fireplace. There's already a fire burning in the fireplace. The old books. I didn't travel all the way back through time just to burn those old books. The workman. He really made a mess of things, and now he's just lying here drunk instead of fixing the roof. I'd really like to light a fire under his butt, but with the amount of alcohol he's had, he's likely to blow up. I think we're done. I think this is all we can do. You know, it's funny, this music shouldn't be playing. Oh, wait. That's not what I want to do. Talk to the library. The old books. I have to travel to the future. Why do you want to go there? No time to explain. Listen up. Okay, so now I got this stuff. They should pixelize this too. Roll of roofing paper. More than enough roofing paper to fix a small hole in the roof. Okay, let's go up. If I simply lay the tar paper on the roof, it will fly away in the first storm. I have to fix it in place somehow. I know, I have the nails. I guess I gotta do that in inventory. I have nails. Do I need the snot? Toolbox is locked and there's no sign of the workman. I'd like to tell you about the future. I'd like to tell you about an exciting time I like to call the future. Not interested. But I must. When I talk about a time or I'm told about one, everything gets dark, and when it gets light again, I am in that time. Humbug. So, in the time of which I speak, there are more colors than here. Not a lot more, but at least a few. Alright.
can I help you?
We can hear you again. Do I still have that doily? Oh, wait, I didn't want to do that. Shut up.
I still have something else to do. Wait here.
With pleasure.
Do I need to go back? I don't have the doily. I need to go back and get that. I'm sorry, I keep doing
Bye.
That.
How can I help you?
I want to go forward in time.
Send me back. Back to the future.
How do I do that?
I need a DeLorean.
Well, I think you just tell me about the future, and I imagine it in detail.
But I don't know what the future looks like. I've never been there.
Well, maybe then I can just tell you. Ah, that's better. Although, well, my eyes have to get used to all this detail again. If I want to save the books, I can only do it in the past. That's where the solution to the problem lies.
I need more troll snot, I guess.
Hi.
Will.
I was in the past. Very strange there.
I was in the past. Everything was very strange there.
A lot has changed in the past few years. Were you able to help the books?
Not yet.
Not yet, but I'm working on it.
Let me know if I can help you.
I have to go. I have important things to do.
Take your time.
Have some more boogers. You have to think about this. Alright. I need something to stick the tar paper with. How do I do that? Will I wet it or something? Won't enough roofing paper to fix a small hole in the roof. They forgot to add in the dialogue. Okay. I should try to figure this out. I know we're into part 3 now. Still haven't gotten rid of the cobwebs.
I'm happy I don't have to worry about them anymore. You just have to know your rights.
Why don't we need to have to worry about them?
Perfectly normal again. Probably the last bit of fireplace travel powder has been burned out.
Actually, it's still green.
I can enter the library through the door now. The fire looks perfect. It doesn't matter. Excuse me, Headmaster Block.
Yes.
About those tasks.
Yes.
About the cobwebs, I found this legal code.
Headmaster, have a look at this.
What do you have?
Heaps of old laws and regulations.
Oh, for law book.
Indeed. Fantastic.
I guess the spiders have rights.
Still valid.
But of course.
As long as the law was not formally repealed, it has the same validity as the day it was adopted.
One of the laws says that government employees under 1.5 meters in height are not allowed to work at heights of more than 3 meters.
Right.
Veritably.
And yet you want me to remove the cobwebs in the hall, the cobwebs on the 5 meter high ceiling.
Oh, of course. Professor Withervane, I wish to formally apologize.
Yeah.
I should not have asked you to perform such a task. I did not know the law.
Ignorance is no excuse.
Exactly.
But I forgive you. Can we then consider the task of removing the cobwebs as off the list?
But of course. Please, leave the book here with me. An old code of laws can be of great help in building a new order.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a funny thing. Ignorance of the law is not indemnity against the law. Something like that. The library's back.
The library's back. And the entrance can be found, funnily enough, in the entrance hall.
Understood.
That was a job pretty well done, right?
Do you want praise every time you are successful in doing something for which you are paid?
Yes.
Yes, please.
Doh.
What I wanted to...
No, never mind.
So, I'll get back to work then.
You are doing amazingly well.
Oh, thank you. There's my praise. I live for your praise, Headmaster.
I can't leave until I've completed the three. I don't want to let you.
Is there anything news going on in here?
Marcus told me everything. I just wish I...
Alright, so there's nothing really to... What we need to do has got to be here in the library. Please send me back into the past.
Send me to the past.
No problem. Listen.
The fire looks quite strange. The flames dance so evenly, and there's no smoke.
Mm-hmm.
No sign of whoever is supposed to repair the roof. The water is just going to drip through come the next storm. Not that it would make any difference for those books now. The books are still rotten. I mean, already rotten. I haven't gone back far enough. The books aren't very helpful. They don't believe in time travel.
Hmm.
Hi.
How can I help you?
Send me back further in time.
Send me a few more years into the past. All right.
Oh, we need a hammer. We need to go back. Okay, I know what we need to do. We need to go back to the workman, get his key for the toolbox, open it and get the hammer. That's what I'm guessing. I can't blame you. Everything was better back then. Listen. And there's a strap with a key on it hanging around his neck, which wasn't available before. The key. A little key, like one for a padlock. The man is wearing it on a thin leather strap around his neck. Take the key. You try to undo the knot in the leather strap, but it's too tight to loosen. I can't untie the knot, and I can't pull the strap over his head either. I can just barely reach it. Use the flap opening spell with the leather cord or strap. You take out your wand and perform some impressive magic. The knot in the leather strap around the drunken man's neck comes undone. The key slips from the strap and sits invitingly on top of the man's fat belly. It's lying on the sleeping workman's stomach. Take the key. You take the key from the fat man's belly and hold it up in the air triumphantly. Da-da-da, got it. Mistake. I already took the key. Okay. Talk to the old books. So they're already old at this point. Alright. The workman had this key tied around his neck. He probably wanted to make sure not to lose it. Open up. Lots of tools. I only need the hammer, though. Beep! The hammer from the toolbox. Nothing special about it. Alright, then. Later. Great sound effects. That's it. The hole is patched and the books are saved. Great. Did you mean that sarcastically? It's always hard to tell when you can't hear voices. No, really. Super. I saved your lives. You shouldn't be making fun of me. And I said that indignantly. You're a hero. I saved these books' lives and you're still making fun of me. At least I think they are. Oh well, the good deed should be thanks enough. Still, a little recognition would have been nice. Hey, you books, hear ye my report of a time that is still to come. I don't like science fiction. There's an additional dimension there. We call it the third dimension.
What's this? Dear Wilbur. Hey, a message from the time travel book. Shortly after you traveled back to your time, I left the library. Lot out there to discover. Time travel must be possible, even without magic and outside of a magical library. Don't you agree? I want to thank you for everything, book friend, for saving those curmudgeonly old books. Above all, for giving me a topic, nay, even more, a passion. Take this gift as thanks. May it always keep your clever head dry. Wow! What a stylish hat!
Stylish. He's got a paper hat. What's it for?
The paper hat of the book friend. I hope no books were harmed in the making of it.
Why are we wearing these hats, by the way? Now Wilbur and Ivo have funny hats.
Old but not rotten. I wonder if they can remember that I saved them. They don't know that they would have rotted without my help. For them, it never happened.
Alright. Well, stay tuned for next episode when we report back to the headmaster and tell him we've accomplished everything. Well, we saved the books. Oh no. What else do we need to do? I don't think he cares that we saved the books. So I'm not sure what we need to do here, but I'm sure we'll find out. Thanks for watching. See you next time in the Bang Bang Boogie, and don't stop the boogie.